Hey gang, welcome to another edition of Doc Schlock, where it's a review of the movie Hell Spa. I don't get it. This one is about a struggling gym owner and a mysterious man who calls himself Mr. X, who goes around and helps out people who are struggling business people, and he helps them out, but of course there's a price to pay. So at this new gym, it pretty much gives you the slogan that you'll lose all the weight you want, look as good as you want, look as good as you want to feel, the whole nine yards, but of course it comes with a price. So, of course, Mr. X pretty much tells anybody that, once you sign on that dotted line, you can't escape, you can't get out of the situation that you're in forever. Or he'll kill you or you'll kill yourself, one of the two should happen. Like he cares. Well, our main hero, Rona, is, you guessed it, she's a struggling gym owner who's trying to make ends meet. And she wants to have a successful gym, too. Mr. X comes into her life, makes everything okay, makes a computer pretty much run things for her, make everything easy. But then when people start coming up missing and dying in the whole nine yards, Rona starts to suspect that Mr. X could be, the devil. Or, actually, to tell you the truth, it's never really revealed who he is. He's just a really bad dude. So, Rona pretty much figures out how to stop Mr. X by putting a virus into the computer, which winds up destroying everything. And we see Mr. X at the top of the building, almost smiling. The computer does a big countdown, and when it gets to one, the whole building blows up, and Rona feels terrible about what happened. Her business she tried so hard to get going and becoming a big success blows up in her face, but gotta blame the computer on that one. And before the movie ends, we see a political something or other meeting up with who else? Mr. X, and he tells the guy, "You need me," and the movie ends, thankfully. Thank God. So why did this movie suck? It's another one of those shot-on-video horror movies that I really can't believe that I missed. I guess maybe it was a good thing I forgot about this movie. It's goofy at times. There are some one-liners if you can pay attention to them long enough. But there's horrible dialogue, pretty bad acting, and the gore effects are pretty bad. I don't think the body count was even that high in this movie. Maybe one or two people. It's just pretty much your low-budget, shot-on-video piece-of-crap horror movie. Some likable characters in the movie, but again, Mr. X, you can't help but wonder who he is, what he is, and then you're just kind of sitting there and stuck there with the feeling of, so we don't know who Mr. X is. He kind of reminds me of that one dude who was the leader of the cult in Halloween 6. Kind of dresses like him too. Not the same guy in the movie, but at least I don't think so. You never know. Anyway, the movie's crap. It's really, really bad. If you want shot on video, piece of crap, horror, this is the movie for you. But after I just pretty much ruined everything for you, why would you want to watch it? I don't know either. But stranger things have happened. So there you guys have it, a review of Hell Spa. Still don't get it. If you like my videos, feel free to subscribe. If you have a horror, sci-fi horror, comedy horror, or fantasy horror movie that could have been shot on video, or could have been shot anywhere, and then you feel like shooting it after it was over with, send it my way and I'll get on it ASAP. Thank you guys so very, very much for watching. And until next time, as always, stay strong and rock on. No, don't get it. I don't get the title. But after watching this movie, you know what I feel like doing? Chowing down on cupcakes and nachos and drinking a big old bottle of root beer.